Well, good Saturday morning. Welcome to another Lord Life's Devotional with Pastor Hayton. I want to just spend a few minutes this morning paying tribute to a very special person in my life. It was September the 12th, 1945, that Carol Esther was born to Orville and Hazel Price. And it would be 16 years later before I would have the privilege of meeting this young lady. But, you know, one day on the campus of Kansas City College and Bible School, I guess I caught the eye of her before she caught the eye of me. But anyway, somehow or another, we became interested in each other and began dating as far as the rules of KCCBS would permit us to date. We had some advantage. Her folks were living in Trenton, Missouri, and my folks were living in Kirksville, Missouri. And it was easy to get a privilege to go home on the weekend. So, you know, since I was going that direction anyway, why, she was able to hook a ride to Trenton. Then I would go on over to Kirksville and see my folks for a little while and hightail it on back to Trenton, where we would court the rest of the weekend. But if the school had known how much time we were spending courting, well, I imagine that they might have discouraged that. But anyway, we were able to spend time together and get to know each other, and it was on June the 14th of 1963, I believe it was, that we became man and wife. And I know that a lot of times we men, we have to confess that our wife is our better half, and she certainly is my better half. Those of you that know Carol know what a wonderful spiritual lady she is, and what a blessing she is to those with whom she worships. And I just want to pay special tribute to Carol today, because down across 52 years and all the moves that we've made, she has never stood in the way of me doing anything that I felt like God wanted me to do. We've lived in some pretty substandard housing, but I've never heard one word of complaint from her lips about the housing that we've had to live in. We made some moves that certainly entailed a lot of changes in her life, and yet I've never heard her complain about that. She's been a wonderful mother to my children. Our four children are great children, and I just attribute their beauty of character, their beauty of personality, much to their mother, who was one that was a great influence and continues to be a great influence in their life. So, you know, the Bible tells us, whosoever findeth a wife findeth a good thing. And I found a good thing in Carol. Not to say that we haven't had our problems. I think every married couple goes through some stormy times. If anybody were to tell you that they've never had any trouble in their marriage, you probably ought to watch them. They'd probably lie about other things as well. Two people living together are bound to have some disagreements. Two people living together are bound to not see eye to eye on some things. And where there are two strong personalities, we're not shy about letting each other know how we feel about things. But Carol has been a good preacher's wife. She has been a great mother to my children. And I just want to wish her a very happy birthday today. Let her know how much that we appreciate the goodness that she's attributed to our life and to our marriage, and how she's such a tremendous blessing in the church that we are pastoring today. I know that if she weren't there, I probably wouldn't be as popular as what I am, but she's just a blessing. And I just want to say happy birthday, Carol, and let you know that we love you and appreciate your life down across the years, and looking forward to celebrating more birthdays with you. You don't really act like a 70-year-old woman, even though you've been through a lot of pain and a lot of distress. And even today, as with every day, no doubt a lot of physical discomfort. Yet we're so happy that you've aged gracefully. And I wish you a very happy 70th birthday. Heavenly Father, thank you for a wife that is been a good wife down across the years, that has turned to be 70 years old. And we just pray, Lord, that you'll continue to bless her life, give her the touch and the help that she needs. Pray that you'll bless each one of us, help us to be a blessing. We ask it in Christ's name. Amen. Well, I just want to share that from my heart. We'll see you Monday on Lord Light's Devotional. Goodbye.